Welcome back to Studio 10. We're talking to Justin Lyons, who for the first time is telling us about the day Steve Irwin died. Justin was the only person underwater with Steve. And this is the very first time you've talked about it, isn't it? I was just thinking about everything you've told us. And I'm wondering what was going through your mind, you know, when you realised Steve had died.
I actually, a sort of a calm comes over you, and I thought, you know, I'm going to have to do my very best here to try and save my mate's life. And so I kind of clicked into, you know, I guess a survival mode. Mm. And so everything that I'd learnt at my St John's Ambulance first aid course to do CPR all came flooding back. I just kind of knew exactly what had to be done. So I had a calmness about me.
Justin, had you and Steve in the past spoken about what might happen? I mean, how you could help one another?
We had this rule that if Steve was ever hurt or injured, that we had to keep filming, no matter what. That was the thing with him. So there was actually another cameraman on board that filmed the whole CPR experience, the whole time we're trying to save Steve. He's filming away. And he said to me afterwards, I did that because I thought that was my way of coping, and also that I thought that Steve would wake up.
You didn't expect him to die.
Mm.
Yeah.
Just keep on filming and he'll be all right.
And afterwards, you know, when he was pronounced dead and you were there with your memories of that dreadful experience, how did you feel? How did you cope?
Well, it was very difficult. When something so traumatic happens like that, you kind of, you know, you reassess everything. I was swimming over the top of that stingray as much as he was. I was interacting with that stingray as much as he was. So it could have just as easily been me. You know, when I called my wife and said, this is what's happened, I thought, well, you know, you've got to stand back and look at the bigger picture. I mean, Steve's gone now, and it could have been me. I could have left, you know, a widowed wife. So I sort of re-evaluated what was important to me, and you look at your loved ones and you look at your life and say, well, what is really important? So it was good. It was therapeutic in a way.
You mentioned the video that you both had decided you had to keep filming regardless. What are your thoughts on that video being aired, people seeing that?
Never. Mm. No, I mean, out of respect for everyone, his family and everything, I would say no, never.
Mm. So do you still have it?
No. I don't know what's happened to it, but I suspect that it's gone. It'll never see the light of day, hopefully.
Mm. So how does someone who'd been through what you went through, how did you get over it, if you ever do get over it? I don't think you do, actually. I think it remains somewhere in your memories.
It does, but I'm actually just working on a project now about how our emotions, or what we call our emotional baggage, can become trapped in our body. So when we have these traumatic experiences in our past, in our childhood or our work or our relationships, sometimes these emotions can get trapped in anatomical parts of our bodies, and they are the root cause of everything that actually ails us. So everything from...
But in a way, when these terrible traumas happen in your life, and I'm thinking about the death of my brother, he died of cancer, you sort of lock them in your heart so that you will remember, because you want to remember.
That's right.
But in your video, Emotion, you're actually saying we have to let that go. Not so much the memory of my brother, but the sadness or the trauma that I associate with it.
Certainly the negative emotions that... What invariably happens is we react in the present moment like an emotion from our past is going on right now. And so we are reactive. Our perception of the world is clouded by these emotional memories. So the trauma of your brother dying may continually resurface in situations that you're put in every day. And it's great to remember, that's beautiful, but actually keeping a negative memory trapped in your body can be very unhealthy.
Mm. Well, it's very hard to get rid of a negative memory. Now, this is the video that you've produced, which I think has helped you cope with the death of Steve. That's the way I see it. I looked at it yesterday and I thought, yes, you must have had to do this video in a way because to help you get over Steve. And so you talk about these negative emotions that we all have. You talk about the subconscious in which all the emotions that have ever happened to us in our entire life is stored, and all of these memories keep coming back and affect the way you behave. That's it, isn't it?
That's absolutely true.
But how do you get rid of them?
Well, you need to watch the documentary.
Well, I did, but we have to tease the viewers a bit.
Because it's a fabulous documentary.
It is. I mean, these guys that we interviewed in the doc, and there's lots of practitioners like this all around the world, and they're everything from medical doctors to quantum physicists to, you know, they're professional people that have done a lot of research into things and how our emotions affect our bodies. So the new sciences of neuroplasticity and epigenetics, about how our brain and our body heals itself once we've been able to change a part of ourselves. And so there are methods, modalities where these guys can identify the emotion, where it's physically lodged in the body, how to release that emotion to bring about bona fide physical change. Mm. And literally some of the case studies we followed were curing everything from depression and chronic fatigue to cancer. So it's really out there, cutting edge work.
Mm. I found it very interesting watching. And I know in my life I do a little bit of mindfulness. And would you say that that's part of that you talk about in here, actually bringing yourself back to the moment?
Absolutely.
What is happening now? Because I think all of us, some way, can get hijacked by our past.
Absolutely.
And we need to sort of live in the here and now.
That's right.
And that gives you peace and a calmer life and a different approach.
It does, but it's also bigger than that. I mean, it's bringing abundance into your life. Mm. It's manifesting the life that you want to live. You want to be happy. You want love in your life. Mm. And these are simple techniques that people can employ every day. You don't have to go and meditate for years in a cave to kind of quiet the mind and bring these things into your life that you want. So if you're feeling a little bit depressed or you are reactive and you get angry in certain situations, these modalities are things that you can do every day, make them become habit. Some simple stuff that, like making your first thought in the morning positive and happy.
Which is such a good message. Yeah. Justin Lyons, thank you so much for coming in this morning, for sharing some of your story with us. We are so very grateful. And it is, as we've been mentioning, a terrific documentary. It is called Emotion and it's out now, and you can download it from the website emotionthemovie.com.au, and we will also have those details on our Facebook site.